more you drink, the prettier we're going to look.
Paul, Anthony and Anthony, they're good people. I think they're going to be,
you know. What I love about them, also that I've been lucky to work with some people that are like you, Kevin Atwood. Now, Kevin Atwood's the most wonderful man. Yes. And people might see Kevin as this and that. Kevin was a dreamer who did amazing things. And if the technology was now, he was there with the technology, he would have done the most brilliant stuff. He did amazing things. Yes. He's great for Melbourne. Ken Payne, who was Three Faces in the Market, again, a dreamer, but with a theatrical background that was groundbreaking and brilliant.
You certainly know. Was. They've given a lot to us as gay Melbourne cultures, really.
But then, like, you get Tom McFeely at the Peel, too. The way he's done that hotel and everything, it's really spectacular.
I
love that whole thing, you know, the look, the whole thing. And what's his name? I think we're very lucky with these men that have that run these, you know, from...
Yes. Sure, they're running businesses, but they're also running businesses for the benefit of our common community.
This is the whole thing. You've and they also support them.
They're also supporting people behind the scenes that you're not necessarily aware of. I mean, I know with Tom McFeely, he is very charitable. He's used to support Bent TV quite a bit. Him and Dale used to support young queer youth, you know, with helping them to get their studies. And
well, this is the whole thing. It's the stories you don't hear. And, you know, I think that's the thing. But also, you've got to have, like, places like these for people to come to. But then the patrons have to support them as well. Yes. Otherwise, we'll have nothing. I remember, like...
These days, everything's being come to online, though, isn't it?
But it's like that. I remember being called into the Exchange Hotel. I remember it was a Tuesday night, and we were all called in. And Kevin Atwood came up and said, look, we're going to close on Saturday night, the last night. And we were all just going, I can't believe this. This is not happening. It can't happen. It's ridiculous. You take the DJs, everybody. We're not just talking about three drag queens here. We're talking about the other 30 people that go with the whole thing.
Yeah.
But also nobody. But on that Saturday night, we had 500 people in the place. And people kept coming up to me and saying, why are you closing? Well, we're closing because you didn't come and support us.
That's right.
This is the whole thing.
Because it's business and it's not making money.
Yeah. And that's the same thing with the Greyhound and all that. I mean, the Greyhound gave the most brilliant shows in Melbourne. Or perhaps the world. And whether you like the owners or not, you've got to support it. You've got to support this.
Yeah.
To make it like work. I think I'm about almost ready to rock, aren't I?
You're looking more like Candee every minute.
Oh, looking more like Candee. So that's kind of... I think
now, it's just funny, your voice hasn't changed throughout this process.
People say, my voice is... I've got a good voice, so that's fine. I'm just allowed to be deep and whatever.
Now, can we just...
You gotta have boots if you want to impress tycoons and roots. You need boots to fill out a sweater. You need two, but three might be better. And that's one in the back for dancing. Do 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 do. You gotta be stacked. Hey, you gotta be grouped. Individual, in fact. For with boobs, you can start a romance off. Make a man stand right up and take his hat off. I know it doesn't rhyme, Ducky, but it does keep me legitimate. To make a fool for the earth and mother, even a cow has to show her udders. You gotta have boobs. B-O-O-B-S. Some push them up, some stick them out, and some keep them flapping in the breeze. Some tie them down, because if they don't, they would hang down to their knees just to tease. You gotta have boobies if you want men to offer diamonds and rubies.
But I've got to get this thing out here now. I know I'm really
doing it, right? Yes, you do.
Everybody gets to go to the moon, you see.
Yes.
And I love the song as well.
Yes.
That song.
Yes.
For the 3 degrees.
Yes.
Everybody's done it. Well,
well, maybe back in the 60s and the 70s it did, but...
No, but Whitney Houston, not Whitney Houston, Gloria Gaynor did it.
Okay.
I did the whole YouTube thing on it.
Oh, wow. Because I hadn't heard that song really...
It was in the Gene Hackman movie.
Okay.
I can't think of...
Who?
The famous one. The really famous movie, the heist movie. But so I did the whole thing on it. Yeah. And actually, that song is not new.
No, it's an old song, but I...
No, but that song, they actually... Susan's done it before. She's done it with Rita.
We've got half an hour, but you've got to pull your finger out. All right, let's stay on.
Is that Terry?
That's Terry Tinsel and Minx.
Do you look alright?
You look fabulous.
So we've got that, I've got to do that, I've got to do that. Do we have a t-shirt I can show? You've bought boys just going to wear the t-shirts.
Yeah, because you're going to turn around.
Oh my god, you are the diva. The diva babe.
The diva dudes.
Yeah, I think she's too far away.
My goodness, what a camp night.
Okay, technical issues.
On our end.
Hello. Reese, I'm losing you. I might take myself out.
Is that Candee down there?
We shan't talk about the effigy's name.
I know that, see, Nova's got a ring light, my ring light on her. So, that's better.
The others are just way too bright.
Can you see the screen all right, Candee?
Can you hear it okay?
All right, ladies, we might leave you there because we've got our next guest.
Because what we're going to do as well, if it works.
There's a noise coming from out there. What's that?
I was probably the TV. Oh, no, it's the lights.
Well, to her, I say, yeah, welcome to the Twitter. I'd rather be a has-been than a mess.
Some positive words to leave us with. All right, Rita and Terry, thank you very much. Lovely to see you. We'll see you a little bit later. Mwah. Minxie, we'll bid you farewell and we'll see you a little bit later too. Mwah, mwah, mwah. All right, my...
So are you the operator? I just don't want to be in your way. I guess you should sit there and be ready to turn him, shouldn't you?
Now, boys and girls, I thought that we would wrap up the show, and it's not finishing yet, so don't worry, but it is getting towards the end. We are going to get on the cherry on the cake. Boys and girls, please make her welcome the matriarch of Melbourne drag, the one and only Miss Candee!
Oh, hi, how are you?
Good, you look fantastic.
No, fabulous!
Oh, there you go. Now we can see you. Gorgeous. Now, Candee, thank you so much for joining us on the show. You've managed to...
I had nothing else. This is normally the night I do my washing.
Good point. Now, you've worked out the technology. So, well, how does it feel to be on a video? Like, how does it feel?
I've been pornos before. Before we go any further, I have been in pornos before.
Right.
I didn't know it, but look at this. Can you see that?
Yes, I can. Oh, my. That's actually you.
It's me, and it's in a porno with some Asian chick on it, and it's all done in Asian. You can just see it. Can you see it? It's all done in Asian.
Yes.
And I didn't know. I mean, I came here tonight when I got given this by not a fan, by somebody who doesn't like me. And to cut a long story short, it took me a while during lockdown
to
find out what it says. And do you know what it says?
What does it say? Tell us, Candee.
Fat girls like cock.
Oh my God. Candee, just bear with me a sec. My cat's jumping all over my cords. I have to fix this up. Sorry. Now, do go on, Candee. What have you been up to during lockdown?
Watching my porno. And the horrible thing about it is I don't remember doing it, but it was the 90s. And I was drinking.
Now, well, I'm actually good, Candee. You know, like everyone else, I'm waiting to get, you know, out into the real world again. Can't wait to get back on stage. And get a route, absolutely. Have you got any men for me? I was going to ask you about some dating tips while we're in this weird position. Have you got any dating tips for us?
Go to Bunnings.
Oh.
Sausage sizzle.
Right.
Do with this. Yeah, go to Bunnings, and I do it regularly, like 7 days a week. Yep. I get on number 246 bus to Collingwood. You get there about 7:15. The tradies are there. You wear a very, very short skirt.
Yes.
I borrowed some short skirts and dresses from Didi Francis, as I call it. And you don't wear any underwear. And you put a trowel in your hand, for God's sake, and you keep bending over a lot, dropping the trowel. And the thing is, you will find Mr. Wright. If you don't find him, basically on the ground floor, just over where they've got all the aisles where they have like the specialty things like doors, there's a shit house. And you go in there and blow him. That's my dating.
That's a good bloody tip. I wouldn't have thought of that. Thank you, Candee. That's because as you've been hearing, I need a man at the moment. So obviously,
I can't believe you don't have a man.
Me either.
Looks like you.
What's wrong with the world?
I mean, the world has gone crazy.
What a world, I tell you what.
Hey, come on, let's make drag great again.
Absolutely.